Hi friends, welcome to Code Linux. This session we are going to start with AWK. We can also call it as awk part 1. Just like I have taken SCD in parts, I am going to take AWK or awk in parts. So in this part 1 we are planning to learn what is awk, syntax of awk, how awk works. What is awk? First the question, what is awk? Awk is basically a command, we know, and it is a filter command also. Just like how grep, sed and various other filter commands are there, no? Cat, head, tail, sort, unique, like that. AWK is also a filter command. That is, it reads input from the keyboard and sends processed output to the monitor by default when issued without any arguments. Okay, so awk is a file processing filter command and also a scripting language. Apart from being a filter command, it is also a scripting language. Then syntax of awk. Awk syntax is like this: awk followed by options if any, followed by within a pair of quotes AWK script. So while actually working, we will see this blow up of that script. Okay, then input file or a set of input files. How awk works? So given any file as argument, first what it does, it scans a file line by line. It reads line by line, first line, second line, third line, fourth line, like that. It scans file line by line. First it reads first line. After reading first line, what all it does? Splits each input line into fields, meaning for example first line it reads, then in that first line, okay, it splits that line into input fields, it splits that input line into fields, okay, based on a specific field delimiter. Okay, we'll be learning how actually it is done when we work with the AWK command. Okay, it splits into fields, that line, based on the field delimiter, field delimiting character. Compares input line fields to pattern based on condition checked in the script. So whatever condition we check in the script, based on that it compares. Okay, it compares either a field or the line itself, okay, any particular field, okay, it compares. Then it performs the specific action or actions, a set of actions on matched lines as specified in the script. Whatever actions we have specified in the script, those action it performs. So this is the basic nature of work done by awk. So it reads line by line, it splits, after reading line by line, what it does, it splits the red line into fields based on the field delimiter specified, and the default field delimiter for awk is space character. So then what it does, it compares input line or fields to pattern, to a particular pattern based on the condition checked in script. Whatever pattern we have specified in the condition, it looks for that particular pattern. We can even check for pattern using regular expressions also. Okay, it performs specific actions on matched lines as specified in the script. Now let us move on to the command line to start working on awk. Okay, so the awk syntax, as I told, is like this: awk followed by options if any, followed by awk script, followed by input file or files. Okay, let me put a hash. Okay, fine. So this awk script, it can be blown up into two parts. This awk script can be blown up into two parts. One is selection criteria, or we can, in short, we can give condition checking part, condition part. Okay, one part is condition and the other part is, okay, just a as an indication, I'm giving it in this angular bracket. This doesn't mean that it should be given in angular bracket. Whatever is given in angular bracket, it's just in that place some condition should come. Okay, so angular bracket won't come at all. Okay, this is just an indication that over there some condition would come. And then action part, action or actions, any number of actions for the particular condition, I can specify any number of actions. Okay, so this is the syntax of awk. And we have seen how awk works. There is, we have just discussed orally that it reads line by line. Okay, for example, it reads a particular line, say nth line. Okay, that line it splits into fields based on the field delimiter specified. So how do you specify the field delimiter? We'll come to that. Okay, based on the field delimiter specified, it will read line by line from the file, split it into fields. Okay, and then applies, after that it applies the condition specified on the field or on or any particular field or set of fields or the line itself. It applies the condition based on what you have specified in the script, what command, what statement you have specified in the script, conditional statement you have specified on the script. It will check the condition, and then for whichever line that condition is satisfied, it will take the action, it will perform the action or the set of actions. So that is how AWK works. Okay, let us try working with AWK. LS-L output, on the output of LS-L, I'll try to work with the AWK script. So with the AWK script, what I want to do, I want to get only the size and name of the files. Okay, so how do we do that? So size is 5th field, name is, name of the file is 9th field, correct? Okay, so ls-l, pipe it to, see, before going further, let me reiterate one more thing. Awk is a filter. Awk is basically a filter command. So being a filter command, okay, it reads, it can read input from keyboard, it can read input through input redirection, it can read input from the file specified as argument. Okay, it can read input from pipe also. Okay, so it can read input from these sources. It can read input from keyboard, it can read input from a file input redirection, it can read input from a file specified as an argument, it can read input from the pipe. Okay, now we are passing input through the pipe to the awk command. Awk hyphen capital F. Hyphen capital F option is used for specifying the field delimiter. What is the delimiter in, for what is the field delimiter? The default field delimiter is space, but still it's a better practice. Even if it is a space also, you can specify hyphen capital F space. Okay, then we need to check the condition. Okay, condition is something like if that dollar zero, let me come to the point, what is this dollar zero, I will tell you. Okay, if the dollar zero starts with, okay, equal to tilde, starts with hyphen, for that file, what I want to do, for that line of input from the long listing output of ls, what I want to do, I want to print dollar $5 comma dollar $9. Let me now explain you. Okay, fine. Then whatever is the script that follows, okay, the awk command, that should be specified within a pair of quotes. There won't be any input file followed because input awk is reading from the pipe, right? Fine. Now let us try to understand this. I told you that based on the delimiter, okay, it reads line by line. Okay, it reads one particular line of input. Okay, based on the delimiter, that is, what is that? Your field delimiter, which is space, it splits the entire line into fields. But what is this dollar zero? Dollar zero is the entire line read by awk. The entire line read by awk, it assigns to the dollar zero variable. Since dollar zero, dollar one, dollar two, dollar three, they are all predefined variables in awk. They are special variables which stores information about the input line. So the input line itself, the entire line read by awk, that is stored in $0, and then $1 stores the first field, okay, which is retrieved. Okay, $2, second field. I could have very well given $1 also. See, instead of $0, I could have very well given $1 also, because $1 is the first field, no? So the first field value starting with hyphen, meaning regular file. So which are all the lines of long listing output, it would be starting with hyphen for the regular files or the ordinary files. So I want to match all the ordinary files. And you would have observed one more thing. Instead of using the double equal to comparison operator, I use the equal to tilde operator. This is known as pattern binding operator, pattern binding comparison operator, equality operator, pattern binding equality operator. When you want to compare with a regular expression, you are not comparing with the exact string. If you are comparing with an exact string, then you would be comparing with double equal to operator or exclamation equal to, there is not equal to operator. But when you are comparing with a regular expression, when your RHS of your comparison is a regular expression, see, beginning with hyphen, I have used a regular expression, or not necessarily only regular expression, maybe you want to compare with the part of a string, a particular substring of the string, then also you will be using this pattern binding equality operator. This is known as pattern binding equality of operator of awk. Okay, so then you will be using this pattern binding equality operator. So what does that mean? This mean if the first field begins with hyphen, okay, then what we want to print? We want to print $5. In that line, we want to print $5 and $9. What is $5? Size of the file. $9, name of the file. Now let us check whether it outputs correctly. Syntax error at or near line 1. Let us check it out. Okay. ls-l pipe it to awk hyphen capital F, okay, space $1 tilde. Yeah, it's not equal to tilde, it is tilde. Okay, so equal to tilde would be in Perl script. The pattern binding operator in Perl script is equal to tilde, but in awk script it is just tilde. Okay, so keep it in mind, in awk script the pattern binding operator is tilde. Okay, but the definition what I told is same, like when your RHS is not an exact string, you are not matching the exact string, but you are either matching a part of the string or you are matching a regular expression, something beginning with some hyphen or ending with something, or any regular expression you are using as a part of the RHS in your comparison, then you will be using the pattern binding operator. Okay, so the other things remains the same. So pattern binding operator is tilde. Okay, so keep it in mind. Okay, so let us keep that in mind. So now ls-l, then pipe it to this. So I have explained you the significance of each and everything, the significance of hyphen capital F for specifying the field delimiter in the input line. Then whatever is the awk script, that should be specified within a pair of single quote. And then $1. So what will $0 contain? The entire input line. Okay, $1, the first field. $2, second field. $3, third field. So on. Okay, if $1 begins with hyphen, that is how we need to relate it. Okay, $1 begins with hyphen, meaning $1, pattern binding operator, equality operator tilde, okay, beginning with hyphen. So $1's value is beginning with hyphen in whichever line. In that line, I want to print fifth field and ninth field. Got it? So then it displays exactly the size of the file and the name of the file. Maybe I want to display name of the file and the size of the file. It's very simple. $9, $5. That's all. Then it's so flexible. Okay. So we are able to identify in terms of fields. That is one advantage in awk. Okay, there are so many other things in awk we are going to see in subsequent session. There are so many interesting things we can do with awk. Okay, with regard to files also, data files and all, with regard to some system commands output, we can take action with the help of awk. Okay, we are going to see those things in the subsequent sessions. Okay, so $9 and $5. So names of the files and the size of the files. But you may just wonder, it is not in a formatted way, no? So how do we display formatted output? So that we will be seeing in the next class. So this session purpose is to introduce you to awk, okay, and then introduce you to awk. What is awk? What is the syntax of awk? How awk works? And just one small example wherein we are able to understand, like, when awk reads a line, how it splits into fields based on the delimiter, and what is the value of $0, $1, $2, how we check the condition, what is pattern binding operator, okay, how we use the regular expressions in our pattern, how we specify that RHS within a pair of forward slash. So all those things we have learned as a part of this session. So this has introduced us to the awk. So we are going to go through the journey of awk. So I welcome you to the journey of awk in the subsequent sessions. So with this, we are going to conclude this session. Okay. Thank you. We'll see again in our next session. Just before concluding, a thought. Promise yourself that you will talk health, happiness, and prosperity as often as possible. John Wooden. Yeah, this is very, very true, in the context that whenever people tend to be in groups, meet each other, either personally, nowadays personally has become a rarity, okay, either personally, but it should come soon, okay, personally or virtually, people tend to talk, do the non-positive talks, but talk positive, talk always about health, happiness, and prosperity rather than anything else. So that would basically spread the positivity and pave way for a better world. So this is John Wooden, it's John Wooden's thought. With this, let us conclude this session. Take care. Bye-bye.